Welcome to this session on how to run your tests in parallel using Test Suite Collection. In this session, we will understand what is Test Suite Collection, why and how do we create Test Suite Collection. So we are going to learn what is a Test Suite Collection, why is it required, and how to create and run Test Suite Collection in Katalon Studio. We will also look at some useful tips towards the end of this session. So let us start. In very simple words, Test Suite Collection is a collection of test suites. Let us understand this. In our earlier session, we have seen that we can have multiple test cases in our application, and these test cases can be grouped logically into different groups, and every group can be assigned to a test suite. So we can have multiple test suites in our application. Now we can also assign these test suites to some particular group, and this grouping can be logical. The grouping of these test suites can vary. You can group these test suites by your application modules. You can also group these test suites by the way they are executed. For example, you can have a test suite collection which will run all your test suites on some particular environment using Chrome browser, and then there can be another test suite collection which will run all your test cases on a Firefox browser. So we can do this logical grouping in test suite collection. Let us understand, why do we need test suite collections? So we have already seen that we can group our test suites logically using test suite collection. We can also run our test suites in sequence or in parallel using test suite collection, or you can run your test suites on different environment or a different browser using test suite collection. We will look into it more details. So now let us create a test suite collection and let us see how can we run our tests in parallel. Let us go to our Katalon Studio, and I'm here on my test project that we have been creating in our earlier sessions. This project has three test cases, and we have also created these two test suites in our last session. You can watch the last session to see how exactly do we create test suite. And let us go to our test suite 1, and here we have three test cases, and we have enabled just one test case to run. So let it remain as it is. Let us go to our test suite 2, and here again we have one test case and it is enabled. So we have two test suites. Let us go and create a test suite collection now. So I'm going to this new button and click on test suite collection, and here you can give any name. I am saying test suite collection 1 and hit the OK button. So now we have this test suite collection. Let us see this window. We have this add button. As soon as you click the add button, we get all the options for adding the test suites present in our project. So I am going to add both of these test suites and click OK. Now let us see, you have this run with column. Here we can select the browser. So suppose you want to run it with Chrome browser, we can select Chrome for test suite 1, and for test suite 2 let us keep Firefox. And again, here is the run options. You can check or uncheck to enable or disable the test suite for execution. So here we have added two test suites and we have configured the browser and both of them are enabled. Now you can go to this execution information section here, and here we have this execution mode. You can run the test suites in sequential mode or in parallel. Of course, we are more interested to see the parallel mode. So let us select this, save our test case, and you can hit this execute button, which will start running the test suite collection. So you can see the test suite collection has started. So it should run my test suite 1 on Chrome browser and test suite 2 on Firefox browser. And yes, I can see both Chrome and Firefox browsers are opening up. Let me just split my screen so that you can see both of these executions. And you can see the first test suite, the test case we have recorded for Orange HRM, and the second test suite has test case that we have recorded for Live Charger website, and both of them are completed. Let us go to the log viewer, and you can see everything has passed, and this is the information. Now you can also go to the report section here, and here you will get the report for this test suite collection execution. Double click here, and here you can get the report. It shows the details. Click on the details, and it will give you the details of this execution, the execution settings, execution environment, and then this is the same report that we get after executing a test suite. We will look into reports into more details in the coming section. So this is how you can create and execute your tests in parallel using test suite collection. Let us look at some useful tips. You can add the test suite multiple times inside a test suite collection, and it can enable you to run your test suites on different browsers or different environments. Let us look here. Let us go to our test suite collection, and we have added test suite 1. I'm going to add button, and I'm going to add test suite 1 again. So we have test suite 1 two times, and you can see first time it is running on Chrome browser, and the second time it is running on Firefox browser. So this is how you can run the same tests on multiple environments using test suite collection. Let us do a very quick recap. Today we learned what is test suite collection, why is it required, and how can we run our tests in parallel using test suite collection. In the next section, we are going to see about test execution reports.